Hey guys, welcome to the channel. I usually use Photoshop for my sublimation designs, but I thought I would download and try Inkscape for the first time. And I have to say, I love what I have tried in it so far. So I am going to show you how I created this sublimation design in Inkscape, which is a free program you can download at inkscape.org. I began with a search for some free graphics on Yahoo. For the heart, I typed in free heart graphic, then clicked on the images tab, then chose this pink one to save to my computer. I did the same for the remaining three downloads. I placed all the graphics I intended to use for this design into one folder. We first need to set the canvas size for the design. Click on File, then Document Properties. I chose to work in inches and in the landscape mode. To zoom into the canvas, click on the magnifying glass icon and then left click on the canvas. To zoom out, you can right click on the canvas. Click on the rectangle tool and click and drag over the canvas. Then click on a color in the palette below. This rectangle is temporary, as we want to see if there might be a white background in the imported graphics. Click on File, then Import, then click on the heart graphic. Click Open, then click OK. Click and drag on any of the corner arrows to resize the heart. If the Proportion tab is locked, it will resize equally. If it is unlocked, then the height and width can be adjusted independently. I will just undo the change and keep mine locked for now. Make sure your graphic is highlighted, then right-click on it and click on Trace Bitmap. Click on Multiple Scans, then click on the drop-down box and click on Colors. Change the amount of scans to 3. Then click Update and OK. Close off the box. Click and drag on the traced bitmap. Right click on it and click Ungroup. We now have 3 separate objects. Let's delete the background, the original bitmap, and the rectangle. With your 2 objects selected, right-click on it and click Duplicate. Do this one more time and position and resize the hearts to your liking. If this should happen while you are attempting to move the heart and the outline, you can click on the outline and while holding the Shift key, click on the inner heart. Once the hearts are in position, click on File, then click on Import, then click on the graphic you are importing. Click Open, then click OK. Position the graphic over the heart you will be working with and resize it if necessary to cover the whole heart. Next, click on the icon Lower Selection to Bottom, which is at the top of the page. You can also click on the icon Lower Selection one step several times to get it behind the topmost heart. We are going to use the top heart as a clipping mask, so click on the pink area of the heart. While holding the Shift key, click on the graphic behind it. Then click on Object, then Clip, then Set. Follow the same procedure to import and clip the 2 remaining graphics. You can also use your own photos or graphics to place in the clipping mask. to change the outline color of the heart. First, zoom into the outline. Click on it, then click on any color below in the color palette. To move the hearts or the outlines forwards or backwards, you can use any of the four icons located at the top of the page. Click on the Draw Freehand Line tool. Make sure the smoothing is set to 23.50. Then click and draw your line. If you don't see this text window, click on Text and then click on Text and Font. Click on the text tool and type out your wording. Choose your font and click Apply. Resize your wording so that it's about the length of the line. While the text is highlighted, hold down the Shift key and click on the line. Click on Text. Then click on Put on Path. While the text and the line are selected, click on Path. Then click on Object to Path. Click away from the line to deselect. Then click on the line and hit the Delete key. To rotate the heart and its outline, first click on the outline. Then click on the heart. Right click and click on Group. Make sure that the heart is selected. Then click on it once more. You will notice that the arrows in the corners have changed. Click on the corner arrow and you are now able to rotate your object. Be sure to subscribe to the channel so you won't miss how I printed this design. If you guys have any questions or suggestions regarding this tutorial, you can leave them in the comment section below. If you enjoyed the video, remember to give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel. Thanks for watching, take care, and bye for now.